disparando bien. Mira.
I'm Jose Martinez.
Jose, you live here?
Yes, sir.
So, how did you first find out that there was a fire next door?
Actually, I think my family just started running out, and I had no clue. I was just like, I heard all the noise, and I was just like, oh well, it's not here because nothing like that has ever happened. Come to find out, nope, it was here.
So this was a huge ball of flames here for a while.
Oh yeah, like I come outside and I'm just like, wow, like this is insane, you know? Like, it was erupted.
Completely out of control, right?
Sir.
Can you feel the heat from your house?
Yeah, actually me and my dad were up in the roof and we were trying to hose it down, and like from just standing right there, I could just feel the heat wave just hitting me. I don't know, like it was crazy. I could feel it for sure.
So y'all probably prevented some of the embers from turning your house on fire.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, you guys said it was like something that was okay to do, but it was really my dad who told me to do that. So I was just following his lead.
Probably a smart thing. So you were talking about, so there's probably some homeless guys in here?
It was more like how should I say, like, not homeless people, but like squatters, drug addicts maybe. Yeah, like they've been, this house has been abandoned since like 2010, and it's just, ever since then, you know, you could just tell people would come in and out. I mean, I live in that room right there, and it's like right next to the house, you know, sometimes you hear like rustling going on and you're just like, oh, I don't know what that is. You choose to ignore it because you don't want to go into the big scary crack house next door. So
did you guys see the fire and then call 911, or you heard the sirens and then came outside?
Honestly, I think one of the neighbors called 911. We're not even sure. Like I said, it was just, we came outside and like it was erupted in flames, so we don't know.
Pretty scary.
Yeah, I mean, it was, don't get me wrong, it was.
So these squatter type people that have been here, they've been screwing around the neighborhood for a while, apparently.
Yeah, I would say so.
It's bugging you guys pretty bad.
Yeah, like it's been going on for years, I would say.
And now it's gotten to the point where it's affecting you because you're right next door to this fire.
Yeah, the neighbors said they saw some people in like some, I believe they said Caucasian guys in like hoodies walking around together. They were in the street, and it was a group of four of them. I don't know. That's what they said. I didn't see that, so, but that's what was said.
Could you,
I'll try.
I'll ask him. ¿A qué hora pasó esto aquí en esta casa?
Pasó como hace una hora, yo creo.
Una hora.
Yo creo que tenemos una hora aquí.
¿Y ustedes cómo supieron de todo lo que estaba pasando?
Pues yo escuché todo el ruido que estaba aquí en la calle, pero yo no pensé que nada estaba pasando. So, yo solamente salí cuando escuché a toda mi familia que, hey, pues se está quemando la otra casa. Y pues, ahora estamos aquí.
¿Y ustedes estaban poniendo el agua aquí arriba en el techo?
Sí, yo y mi papá estamos aquí con las mangueras, estamos echándole agua a nuestra casa porque pues no queríamos que se quemara la de nosotros. Estamos bien cerca, como unos, ¿cómo dicen? Como unos 10 pies.
Claro.
So, estamos bien cerca y mi papá pues no quiere que se queme la casa.
¿Y qué de los hombres, de los homeless que están aquí adentro?
¿Qué están diciendo? Pues yo creo que es un problema desde unos 3, 4 años. hay gente que vive ahí y pues, nadie vive en esa casa. Y pues viene gente que usan drogas o no sé qué hacen, pero ahí siempre están.